Hi everyone! Today we are going to learn about a parable that Jesus taught about two brothers. Now a parable is a story that Jesus would tell to help people understand what the lesson was that he wanted them to learn. So, our lesson today is in Matthew 21, that's chapter 21, that's a dog, Matthew chapter 21, verses 28 through 31. So get your Bibles out, you can read along. All right, so the very first thing we do before we start a lesson is what? We pray. So everybody put your hands together, close your eyes. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you so much for this time that we get to spend in your word. Lord Jesus, help us to understand this parable and what you want us to learn from it. Lord Jesus, help our parents to be having a blessed day and just loving the time that they get to spend with their children. Lord Jesus, I just pray that you help our words come out easy and that we have fun learning your lesson. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, so our lesson today takes place in a vineyard. A vineyard is where grapes grow. And you can see them here, and they're on vines. They grow from the ground, and they're on these vines. And when they are ready to be picked, they look like this, right? But you have to pick them. And so we're going to learn about two brothers, and we're going to see what happens today and which one does the right thing. So there was a man. He's the dad. You can tell he has the hat. So he's the dad. And the dad is the owner of this vineyard, and he sees, my grapes need to be picked. It's time for harvesting. I need help. Good thing I have two sons. So he goes to the first son, and he says, hey son, the grapes are ready to be harvested. Will you please help me pick them? And the son says, Dad, you know, I don't want to help today. No, I'm a little bit tired, and I'm not going to help today. Well, that makes the dad not so happy, right? But this boy starts to think about it, and he says, you know, I don't think I really did the right thing. I probably should help my dad. So he changes his mind, and he goes out to the vineyard, and he starts plucking all the grapes off of the vines and getting them ready. So then the father goes and finds his other son. Here he is. The dad's hat doesn't want to stay on. Hold on. Okay, here's the dad. All right, the dad says, son, the grapes are ready for harvesting. I need help in the fields. Will you help me? And this son says, yes, I will help you, Dad, absolutely. Oh, well, that makes the dad very happy. But when the dad goes away, that son says, no, I don't want to work in the fields today. It's a beautiful day. I'm going to go play. So he goes off and he plays. He does not help. That made the dad not so happy, right? So of these two sons, which one do you think did the right thing? Do you have the son who said no at first, but in the end he changed his mind and went and did the thing that the father had asked? Or the son who said the right thing, he said yes, but he did not do it? So which one of these did the right thing? Which one obeyed his father? This one, right? So even though he didn't say the right thing in the beginning, in the end, he did the right thing and he obeyed his father. Jesus wants us to obey our parents. And our memory verse today is, children, obey your parents. And that's in Ephesians 6:1. So chapter 6, verse 1. Ephesians chapter 6, verse 1. And it's, children, obey your parents. Because Jesus wants us to obey. That's how he made us. We're supposed to obey them because they're to teach us. So our craft today, food. We have grapes. We have oranges, strawberries, pineapples, blackberries, strawberry. Oh my gosh, this is going to be so good. But if you listen and obey what I say, you're going to have something kind of fun in the end. So, when you get all of your ingredients, I have mine all cut up. So you cut your ingredients just like the grapes are going to be in little quarters, just like that. Okay, so when you get your grapes cut, you're going to line them up. This is step one. Line them up on the bottom, just in a straight line. Hopefully they don't fall since I'm holding it up. And then you're going to make another straight line going straight up, just like this. What are we making? What is this? I don't know. But if you obey and you listen and you do what we're doing here and you're listening, you're going to have something very fun in the end. Okay, so we have our grapes, but that doesn't look like much of anything yet. Strawberries. We cut our strawberries and we're going to place them just like this, right on the top of that first green line from the grapes. Can you see what it's starting to look like? Like a flower, huh? All right, and now the other side, orange wedges. One, two, three, four, five, six. Oh, two flowers. Look at how pretty these flowers are. Oh, but this one, it needs something in the middle. So we're going to do pineapple right in the middle. And on this side, we're going to do blackberries right in the middle. Aren't those pretty flowers? And look, you can even extend your line down here a little bit more to make it look more like ground. Just like that. All right, so children, obey your parents. Ephesians 6:1, that's your memory verse. And let's go ahead and close out in prayer. Dear Lord Jesus, thank you so much for this lesson. Lord, help us to obey our parents. Help us to just love each other and obey you. Lord, help us to learn your word so we know how to obey you. And Lord, just help us have the best day today. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll talk to you soon. Bye.